guys, so today I want to share another story with you. Today I want to talk about Candy Burris finally gets exposed and she gets fan backlash for it. And then we're going to talk about Evelyn Lozada returns news. Hi guys, we got a lot to talk about today, a lot to talk about. I don't know why I wore this jean dress. I don't really like it and it wrinkles up and I just don't like it. But anyway, we got a lot to talk about. A lot to talk about. So you guys remember the last time I did a video about the Real Housewives of Atlanta? I was talking about how Candy is sneaky as hell and she makes Kenya do all of her dirty work. And you guys were like starting to see, yeah, what I was talking about. Like, yeah, she is kind of a dirty fighter. She set Nene up last season for the ambush of Kenya, remember, at the party. And she just does all kind of sneaky things behind the scenes. She took her she planned the dinner last episode high up in the air because she knew Nene was scared of heights. She is sneaky, 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 okay? That's why I call her Sneaky Candy. But you know what? She's finally starting to reveal herself to the audience of what a snake she really is. Candy's a snake, I'm trying to tell you. And most people are pissed off at Kenya. It's Candy, people. She orchestrates the plan, and then Kenya's dumb enough to carry him through. I mean, dumb enough, brave enough, whatever you call it. But it's Candy here. Candy is the mole. Remember I said that last video, and people were like, oh, you're overreacting. You're a Candy hater. No, Candy is the mole. Cannot be trusted. And she's much more dangerous than Kenya because she plans out her attacks, okay? Kenya will just verbally abuse you. You know, oh, you know. Your mama this, your daddy that, but Candy will think about it, devise something sneaky and execute it, and then when it comes to light that she did something, she'll say, no, that wasn't what I was doing at all. And people have been falling for it, okay? Except for yesterday, she finally exposed her damn self. So we all remember a couple days ago, Nene was on her YouTube channel saying how Candy was scared of Phaedra and she was running from her, scared that Phaedra would come back. So this is what she did to finally expose herself. So she went to her social media and she put together this like short little clip. I don't know. It was basically making fun of Nene, like, oh, girl, please. She thought it was funny. But you know what? People seen right through it. And she got backlash for it in her own comment section. People were like, why are you being messy? You know, why are you dragging Nene? She didn't do anything. And then she played victim like she usually does, Candy. She said, she started with me first. And then she put in the caption, hashtag petty. We know you're petty, Candy. People are starting to turn on Candy and she's not going to be able to hide behind Kenya Moore anymore. People are on to you. And she claims, you know, she just posted that because, you know, they were bored, everyone's in the house, and, you know, she thought it was going to be funny. She thought people were going to like it. But no, what it did was expose who you really are. You're the one that wants Nene off of that show, and I said this before, and people don't believe me, because she wants to be number one. But all this time, people thought it was Candy. No, it's all this time, people thought it was Kenya. No, it's Candy. Candy wants to make the most. She wants to be in Nene's shoes. Bottom line, okay? And all of this time, she's been using other people to do her dirty work. Well, she finally exposed herself yesterday. But as I said in my previous video, knock yourself out, Candy. Keep trying, but you're missing charisma. You will never be in Nene's spot. You're missing charisma. You're boring as hell, and now you are the villain, okay? I'm really leaning towards not liking the bitch. Because I don't like sneaky people. If you just come out and be who you are and own it, yeah, you know, I don't like Nene. I want her gone. I want to be in the number one spot. I give you more respect. But if you keep tiptoeing, sneaking, making other people do your dirty work, I have absolutely no respect for you. And that's where I'm leaning towards Candy. I'm going to give her a small little break only because I want to see the rest of the season play out and if she will pull herself back and control her own damn self, which I doubt. But, you know, there's always a small 1% chance that she might. Like, I'm not liking Candy these days, people. Your little clip wasn't funny at all, and you were being messy, and you thought the crowd was going to join in and also make fun of Nene too, and they didn't. What you end up doing was exposing yourself. I can't stand sneaky bitch people. I hate sneaky bitches. I really do. I cannot deal with sneaky bitches. I like straight shooters. Tell it like it is. You know, that's the only way you can get my respect. I mean, as of now, Candy. You know, and that little crummy spinoff that you're going to have, you have a history, okay? I'm not trying to be mean, people, of having your reality TV shows that you do on your own get canceled, okay? So, you know, I just hope that on your reality TV show, I'll give it a chance, you know, that you're not the center of the show. You are boring as hell. You have to bring in somebody else because you're just that boring. Is that bad? Look, I'm a straight shooter. I like people who tell it like it is, and that's exactly how I'm feeling about Candy Burris today. I mean, her plan blew up. She really tried to get people to turn on Nene and mock her, the whole Phaedra running thing, and they didn't. And you know what? I hope that Bravo does bring Phaedra back. Now, they tried to bring her back last season. It was between Phaedra and Kenya, but they went with Kenya because Kenya took the pay cut. Phaedra didn't. Phaedra wants a big payday. Phaedra, if you want back on that show, you're going to have to take a pay cut and just come back, get your story out there, and then renegotiate the upcoming season. But, you know, no one's going to bring you back if you're asking for a high fee, especially when they are not liking giving high fees to their housewives anymore. They want to cut back. And so, you know, you're shooting yourself in the foot, Phaedra, by asking for more money. But, you know, drop those fees. You need to get back on this show, in my opinion. Now, let's move on to Evelyn Lozada. Now, it's being announced today that Evelyn Lozada will be returning to the upcoming season of Basketball Wives. Okay, so listen. Some people actually thought that the show would not go on because of the whole colorism thing last season. People thought that it was appalling and that VH1 wouldn't bring the show back and that... And if they did bring the show back, then they definitely wasn't going to bring Evelyn back because of her poor behavior. You know, she was acting colorist. She was grabbing her stinking rotten vajayjay. Do you guys remember that? And people just thought, this is appalling. This woman is done. No. Let me tell you why I knew that Evelyn Lozada was returning. Number one, because Shawnee's the executive producer of that show. Okay, so Shawnee is going to keep that show on until the ratings plummet. That's just how she is. She's money hungry and she likes the attention that she gets with the show. You know, she feels like she's accomplishing something, you know, outside of Shaq. So she's gonna keep that horrible show. And it's really slid over the last couple of years. I mean, it's just, last season was the worst. I mean, they acted terrible, okay? And I knew that Evelyn was coming back because Shawnee's her good friend. And that's what they do. You know, they love to camera time. Them two love camera time. And they don't care if they get called colorist or not, okay? That's Evelyn's main source of income, okay? And I knew that this show would come back, and I knew Evelyn would be a part of it. Now, if it wasn't for OG, I wouldn't bother to watch this season. I want to see how OG's going to handle them. Because, you know, she does it very skillfully. I like the way that she does it. Cut corners with them too, and she does not back down. And for any of you who think that Evelyn's the only colorist on the show, no, Shawnee is too. Shitty Shawnee is just as colorist as Wicked Evelyn, okay? I can't believe they brought this show back, but I will watch because I enjoy the way that OG drags the hell out of them, okay? And she makes them accountable, and I like the whole Chad thing again too. By the way, rumors are going around that these two were still texting each other. So, you know, and I love how Chad tried to lie about it. I like that part, you know, of them two getting what they deserve. So I will be watching it. Am I glad that Evelyn's back? I don't like the bitch. Is that bad? She's another sneaky girl, okay? And she's worse than Candy, okay? You know, the whole grabbing her stinking rotten vajayjay, well, that's just disgusting and classless. And they thought that they could get over on OG because they're light and they're pretty. And no one thinks like you. That's old school thinking. You know, you did not get away with anything. You guys exposed yourself for the colorist, petty, childish people that you are, you know. I would not watch this show if it wasn't for OG. And Tammy gave an interview a couple months ago with Keisha Cole. And they basically ran Tammy out of town. Tammy had had enough and said, I'm done with these two. And, you know, and I don't like the way that Shawnee treated her good friend Tammy. She basically threw her under the bus and decided to ride with Evelyn. And so, you know, these two really get under my skin. But, you know, I have to do my job, which is make the announcement that Evelyn will be returning to the show. So, you know, all of you that are happy, you know, kudos. And to who, anyone else who's not happy, you guys should check out how OG drags the hell out of them. I don't think she's going to back down this season either. And so this is going to be good. Okay, you guys, that's my housewife news for you today and my basketball wives news for you today. So we got a lot to talk about in the comments section. What I want to know is, now that Candy has exposed herself as the mole, will she continue to do sneaky things behind Nene's back? And number two, who thought that Evelyn Lozada would not return? Who's shocked? Also, if you like this video, don't forget to click that like button. If you haven't already subscribed and hit the notification bell, go ahead and do that. And I'll see you guys on the next video. Bye.